Hello, and welcome to another Minecraft here in the Sky Factory. Since this is a second series, not my primary, you may not see one of these every week. And what I'd like to do is see if you are watching these, leave a comment to say if you like to keep watching them or not. Because you know, it takes effort to do two of these series, and doing one already and then doing this one as well just takes time. So let me know if you're enjoying it. If you're not, then maybe we won't do this one. We'll see. But for now, we'll do another episode of the Sky Factory. We'll get some pumpkins since we're here, and they can't grow until you get pumpkins. So just to recap what we've done, we have created our little generic vanilla farming, basically. We have our pumpkins, we have lighting. These are all jack-o'-lanterns. So we have lighting over here covering the water, so we can just kind of, if we need potatoes or if we want wheat for bread, or we have carrots, we have our sugarcane farm here. And then we got our trees here, our mob farms over there running. I did some upgrades to that. I'll show you that in a second. And then, you know, two lines of trees. I was tired of basically standing here grabbing the items, putting them into the chest. So I made an advanced item collector, mainly so it'd reach and it pulls everything out of there into this chest. So every once in a while I have to just check this chest. I've been moving the bags over to here, and then making these epic or legendary loot bags when I can. So every time I see some bags, I'll pull them out of there. And as you see, I don't have any there. And then I'll just put them in to the rows, and four of them make the next one up. So that's how I've been getting these legendaries. Okay, and I put in some safety rails because that's always a great thing. And I have a chest there where I've been putting gunpowder, just to free up space in these chests until we get our next chest that we're going to build. And I've been getting ready for that. I don't know if I have enough of them yet, but we'll see. Anyway, and that's what these are. That's our, we have these colossal chests. That's what we're going to be building. We saw this last time where I made the automatic hammer, and the last episode was short. I apologize, but I was having, my dog was sick, and so we were trying to figure out what to do with that, and you know, it was just it was not a great day. So basically what I have is this hammer is hammering cobblestone, which right now I don't have automatically fed in there, but we can pull it out of here and put it into there. We will get that automatically done. Right now this is also feeding this. We need to get one more fluid and transfer pipe to get this fully done to fill up this tank. But as you can see, we're ahead of the game for the tank. We have our generator. It's kind of maintaining here, which means it's using the energy it's producing. So we probably need some speed upgrades to really do anything else requiring power. But you can't do speed upgrades until you have grid power, because if you put in a speed upgrade, it will start taking grid power, and we don't have any grid power made yet. So that's going to be on our list. We do have some of these resources. I have automated, or semi-automated, the making of dirt. We still have to come along here. We have our rotten flesh I've been putting into there. So all we have to do is click on these, and then they'll fill back up, as you can see, from the rotten flesh. And then I just throw the dirt into there. As soon as we can get some Ender IO conduit, We will can't talk. We will probably remove all this and make a different place for it. So, okay. That hopefully keeps you up to date. What I've been doing is trying to keep our iron production going. We don't have any automations going on at this point. So, it's a huge manual process at this point. So, I kind of have to do that. And then I do this. And then I do that. I don't know why I kept that in my inventory. And then I just dump all that into the furnace. And it will make them dump them into this chest. So basically, I see four of those. So I make that into the ore. And dump that into the chest as well. And we will make this better, but we're just not quite there yet. So, and then over here, this is where I've been cooking food, or if I, you know, need some glass or something. So this is a lot of major grind at the moment. Now, these chests have been getting filled up. As you can see, this one's totally full. I'm gonna have a bunch of charcoal, have some clay and some other stuff. Plus we got some food items and trees. We have some more of these seeds, and it's kind of hard to figure out what I got. So I got three of these, I got two of these. I need to get a fluid to finish that off. And then I got some more items in here. I got more items over here. So I know when we get to the ME system, it can hook into a chest. So instead of having to make the drives and all that, I can just hook it into a chest. But as you can see, the chest can't hold that much. But a colossal chest can hold a lot. So I've been making these things. So hopefully this will be enough. There is a couple items that we do have to make, and we'll show you what those are. So if I type in colossal chest down here, colossal, never can spell it, colossal chest, we're going to need the chest core, which is just an iron ingot, and I don't have the iron ingot, but over here I should have an iron. Silver, nickel, no iron. Okay, that's exciting. Let's go over here. And now we got some iron ingots. Okay, so now we're going to need the chest core. Dump that in there. You need one of these for each of your colossal chests. Only one. It's all you need. Now, to hook anything into it, you're going to need some of these chest interfaces. Okay. And that's just cobblestone in one of those. So let's get some cobblestone. We got 29 of those. I don't know how many we're gonna need. Let's see. 17, 20. Let's just get some more. That gave me 61. So that's good. So now I can. Let's just do this. So 15 of them. Is that all I can make? Yeah, for now. And that's probably more than plenty. We don't really need a lot of those. Because you're going to have the ME system take up one spot. Probably an ender chest. And that leaves 13 more for whatever else you want to hook into it. I like the ender chest, but we'll need blaze rods for that, and we can't even come close to blaze rods until we can get to the nether and fly. It's kind of what we need to do. So let's get rid of some of this stuff. Probably don't need any of that. We don't need any of that. We'll throw that into there. Just because we want to free up some space, we'll keep... No, we'll just keep all that. That's okay. Okay. So. We have gravel there. We have all this cobblestone here. Let's figure out where we want this colossal chest to be. And like I said, I had another world where I was doing this kind of stuff. And I had made this device called a World Builder, I believe it's called. Let's look at that. World Builder? No, let's just try Builder. Builder. Okay. So this little guy right here. And this is an awesome little thing. You have to make some bricks. So you have to make clay into bricks. Got to make a machine frame, which is pretty easy. Just some standard items. And what you would do is put a chest on top with your cobblestone or whatever. You build a shape card, which is one of these. And you can have different kinds, quarry and all that. But this is the one that I was talking about. So again, more redstone, more brick, paper, and iron. And then you would define the shape card and what you want to build, and it will build it for you, which is pretty cool. Takes power, and we would probably suck up all the power we have at this point. And I'm not sure that's what I want to do at this point. So I think what I may do is put... Where do I want this chest? Because I could put the chest up here. And then I can have the ME system like on the second floor here. Right here. Or I could have the ME system down these stairs. And then I can put the chest up here. Which may be what I want to do. That might be cool. We could put the chest on a platform going that way too. That would be interesting. Okay, so let's do that. we'll ignore the dirt for now. Okay, so if we're going to do that, let's go ahead and do this. We'll do, well, I don't want to do this, but we're going to anyway. I'm going to make one of these diamond mine or wands. And the reason I made a diamond is you've seen, maybe you've seen, I believe you've seen, that I've done this with stone wands, and that's awesome. Except, they don't last that long. These diamond ones do bigger distance, and they last a lot longer, so I'm going to go ahead and use it for this, because I don't want this to take forever. So 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. So then we'll go 1, 2. That'll leave one on each side. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, and one extra. Okay, so now you'll see the power of the diamond line. So I can do that, and it will line that up. I can do this. And as you can see, this will also go up. So if I wanted a double layer, it'd be fairly easy to do. But right now we're just building our platform. About three more. You gotta be careful. Nope, two more. Okay, so one, two. Okay, so now we're gonna get rid of the cobble. We'll just jump off here. And we'll get rid of this. And we'll get this stuff. Because we need all of these, well, as many as we can hold. Okay. Now, I may have made too many of these, but that just means I can make more than one, which is pretty cool. Okay, yes. Not the greatest idea. But luckily, I have a bow. And I'm not as scared to use it. Forgot it's nighttime. So let's go ahead and turn on our, we want to make sure we don't have any more mobs spawning. Probably should do that. We do have some good loot that was dropped. Well, not great, but good. So let's go ahead and fine, we'll just dive off the other. Let's free up a little space just so we can pick that up. Come up here, run around, pick up some of this stuff. Okay. Now, I don't think mobs can spawn on this block, so that'll help us. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Okay, so it's becoming daylight, so that's awesome. So let's get rid of that and 1, 2, 3. We have to get rid of these, otherwise it's just going to skip that block if there's a light on there. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Get rid of more torches. 10, 11, 12, 13. 14, 15, 16, 17. And I was standing there. Okay, so now we'll go ahead and put some torches on there. We'll jump up here. What do we got over here? Put one there. Okay, and we should probably be good on this side. Torch there, and that should be good. Okay, so now that we got that done, let's go ahead and figure out where we want our interfaces to be. We'll put, our core is going to be in the middle, so I'll just put a torch to mark that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10, 17. Well, it's half of 17. 16 would be 8, so it'd be the ninth one. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That should be our center spot. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, triple checked. So, what we will do is we'll put an interface there. We'll go ahead and put one there. Let's go ahead and put one there. There. Let's put one like that on all the corners. That'll work. That way we'll always know if you're at a corner, you'll get one. Okay. We're going to have the core go there. So we could go two off the core. And then let's see. Two off the core. And then we got three left. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, that's the center. We'll put one in the center there. And we'll just hold on to this other one. Okay, so we're good there. So let's go ahead and fill in this row now. And when you're building one of these, you do not fill in the center. Center is completely hollow, but you have to fill in all other sides. So you make just a huge box. Now, somebody said in one of his videos that you had to make it odd, but I don't believe that's true because I saw somebody make it 16 by 16 by 16. I'm not positive if you even have to make it square, but I wanted square, so it works. Okay, so there's that. And that's where the core is going to go, and I want to build everything and then put in the core last. So now I'm going to do this all the way around. And then it'll be wand time. You'll see what I mean in a second. And this is why I made the diamond wand. You will see that it saves so much time. For one, a stone wand won't let you go up. It will only go to the side. So I would have done the top and then the bottom. Well, reverse that bottom and then the top. And that's all I would have been able to do. The rest would have been by hand. But with this little thing, as you can see, it's going to go around the corner. So if I jump, it'll do that. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. So then all I gotta do is put a row along here. And by the way, I'm not sure how I'm getting down, but we'll figure that out. So now that I got a row along here, let's see how many I got. Oh, I'm going to need more of those. So yeah, I'm not only going to have to get down, I'm also going to have to make it back up. And I do not have any water to jump into. Well, let's see if we survive, guys. Let's try to jump in the middle. Okay, here we go. Oh, only half my hearts. That's not bad. And I don't need to eat, so they should be coming back. Okay, now you're kind of seeing why I made so many of those chest things, because I had a full inventory and I still need more. So we'll go ahead and take the rest of these. I'm sure that will be enough. We'll just dump, let's see, we'll put this junk in here for now. Yeah, and one of these. Okay, do we have any ladders in any of our stuff? We do have some ladders. Awesome. Now, do we have any wood? plenty of cobblestone here. We'll take a stack of that just in case we need it. And while we're here, we'll put the arrows up there. We'll grab, have an empty hand. There we go. We'll take a bucket of water with us. Should have done that the first time. You know, I'm sure you were all screaming, but take a bucket of water. But I didn't listen. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. So I don't think I can put ladders on the side of this, but we're going to try it because I've never tried it. Yeah, so you cannot do that. But what I can do is nerd pull up, which means I can just break my way back down. Probably didn't need the water, but hey, I got it just in case. Okay, so now with the wand, I can just kind of finish this out. And that's how long a diamond wand lasted. So we can just finish this out, I guess. It'll take a little bit longer, but I don't want to waste another diamond. I don't have that many yet. We need to do a lot of upgrades. Need to upgrade my sifting. Probably will end up with maybe 4 sifters. We'll see. Hopefully. One thing you don't want to do when you're doing this is fall into the middle of this. Reason being is, these things don't really break that quickly. So with an axe or a pitchfork or a pickaxe, I mean, we'll see, because I placed one wrong. I wasn't paying attention. Wasn't focused. Need some more of these. Okay. So you would think they're made out of wood, an axe. And an axe didn't do too bad. But a pickaxe is a lot slower than that. Okay, there we go. Let's go ahead and put one of these in. There's that. Last bit. Let's go to this one. So we will have some to make either a smaller one of these, or we can just wait and make a bigger one. But I can tell you, I've not filled one of these up yet. So it'll be good. And it's getting nighttime again. So it took us just a day. If I would have had to do this by hand without the diamond wand, we would probably be still working on one wall, one side of walls. But now we got it almost built. Okay. Now for the piece de resistance. That's the core. Are you ready? Lag! Okay, wait for it. We're thinking. And we shut down. Hello and welcome back to a Minecraft Let's Play with Painful Fodder. And here we are. After the crash, yes, building this jazz crashed. And what it was doing is changing the render onto the chest to look like that. So if we click on it, if you look, the lid actually opens. It's pretty cool. So let's go ahead and look at the inventory. Look at all that space. So I can start dumping things into it. And we'll keep those out. Now, I'm going to tell you right now, this chest is a major pain in the hiney, because as you can see, I'm going down one line at a time, and the scroll bar really isn't moving. That just tells you how much stuff this can really hold. It's a huge amount of stuff. So, until you get an ME system, you're probably going to spend a lot of your time looking for things inside of this huge chest. But once you get the ME system, there's a search on it, especially if you get the crafting terminal, which is what I would do. And from then on, you'll love it. What you need is a external storage. We'll look at it real quick. I mean, we're a little ways from building it, but let's see. External storage port. So you need to make some of these, which means you need a solder. Any chest will do. You need a cable. You need some quartz enriched iron. So we have to build some more machines before we can even get close to making any of the ME stuff. So, what we need to do is make sure this thing keeps doing what it's doing. And we need to start sifting more types of things. We need to get some grid power so we can upgrade our power, because, you know, this did catch up because this stopped having things to do. So let's give it some more stuff to do. So we'll go ahead and throw all this in there. And then we should be good to go. Now we're going to make probably a few of these little guys here. We're going to expand this as well. But for now, let's go ahead and start clearing things out. That's just that. Let's see what we got here. We'll take all this. Yeah, we don't need that. And one thing I will do as soon as I can is have a chest downstairs that will feed straight into this, so I don't have to be running up and downstairs all the time, because this will get annoying. Okay, so we dump all that in there. Now we can come back down. We might also make an external storage for or stairs to get up there, so we don't have to go through the house all the time. So let's go ahead and move some more of this stuff. We just want to get as much stuff as we can in there. Probably won't need the hammers and stuff, but I'll dump it in there for now. So, get all this junk. Okay, what else do we got? Probably some of that. Go ahead and just dump this stuff there. That'll make this a little quicker. So that should be these two empty. Rotten flesh we're leaving there. do this. So basically from this, nope, that was not good. Okay. We have potatoes, but I want baked potatoes. There's my baked potatoes. We'll put the arrows there. Hopefully that'll keep me from doing that. So we'll get some more stuff. Like I said, rotten flesh. Okay. That and hopefully this will last. What do we got there? So we do got some machine blocks, that's cool. Get all this stuff in there. And like I said, I will not like this until we get everything through the ME system. So that's that, that's that. This is empty. Okay, so let's go ahead and get rid of a couple of these chests that we won't need. That one we'll need. These two we won't. There's that. Probably won't need this chest, but we gotta be careful. We don't really want to fall down. And we'll leave that crafting table there. We're gonna leave this chest and that chest. We'll get rid of these two chests. And you want to be close to the chest when you bust it, otherwise you won't suck it up into your inventory. So now we have some holes we have to deal with, but we do have all of the stuff in here. And as you can see, if you need to find something, it's going to be kind of hard. But if you double click with your center mouse button, it should organize things by name. Hasn't done that yet. Or whatever button you decided. Hopefully it's not crashing again. Don't crash. Sorting a chest this big. And basically, it's like 17 times 17. So 17 squared number of chests of stuff this thing can hold. So that's a lot of stuff. There, it's sorted. Now, how it sorts, I don't really know, because T or oak, it's not come before C, but at least the stuff's together, so I suppose that's better than nothing. And it won't stay sorted. I mean, I'll have to sort it again. That's why the ME system would be preferable. So, let's see. I probably should have seen. We gotta fix those holes or I'm gonna fall through. So let's go through. We're fixing the holes. Let's take some of those. Because having sticks with you is always a good idea. So let's fix the holes. There's that. And there's that. No other holes. Okay. So let's go ahead and make another crafting table. We're going to need four of those. Put them in because we'll probably want a crafting bench up there. Just because it'll be a little more convenient. Now just to explain, this is our core. And you can see on the top, it tells you kind of what that is. That's a wall, it's a core. This is our interface. There's an interface there, some interfaces over there. We're going to expand this platform, but we'll probably do it with half slabs. So, don't need to do that right now. So, what do we need to do now? Probably need to get this stuff going. So there's that, and let's see. Six should be divisible. 32 should be divisible. 24 should be divisible. 3 is not. And neither is that. Those two guys are. Okay. We're going to go up here. We're going to dump off a few things. Mainly that. We're going to go ahead and make these into our, whatever they are, ore chunks, which we'll put in the furnace when we get back there. But what I want to make is another cobblestone generator. Come on. Cobblestone generator. Now, we'll probably increase this one some, but we're going to need cobblestone. We're going to need some glass, and we're going to need a water bucket and a lava bucket. So, let's see what we got in here. We're going to need some glass, cobble. We have plenty of cobble. That's great. We have plenty of glass. That's great. So now all we need is a couple buckets. And while we're here, let's go ahead and take some of these just in case I don't find the buckets. I know I got one downstairs. There's another one. That's cool. We got our little piece of redstone, but we aren't going to need that. Let's go ahead. Yeah, let's just do that. Okay, so now while we're here, let's dump this stuff off, which means we can pick up this bucket. Okay, so we need a water bucket. We need a lava bucket. And now we should be able to craft a cobblestone generator. So that's one cobblestone generator, and since we used iron buckets, we get to keep them. Now for this, you got to upgrade it. That's why I brought the iron. We don't have enough to do the diamond yet. At least not that I'm aware of. But let's see what else we can do. What I'd like to do is make some of this stuff. So we need pulsating, so we're going to need an alloy smelter, and we'll also need some of this, which is probably need bonder composite. Okay, so we could probably make this sand gravel. I got plenty of gravel. Heck, I got a couple stacks right now, so all I need to do is get some sand, and that's fairly easy to do. I just do this. Now, that's going to finish that gravel, and it's turning it into sand, so We'll let that run a little bit. So that was for the conduit. The only thing is this. So I need an alloy smelter, and I don't believe I've made one. I'll probably need more power, though. What to build first? Alloy smelter. What does this take? Okay, furnaces, a cauldron, machine chassis, which I think takes some redstone, gold, and a copper ingot. I don't think we're ready for that yet. I don't think we have any copper. Yeah. Okay. How about a crusher? See what a crusher takes. Redstone. Oh, we can't make any of that stuff either. Okay, so we're quite a little ways away from that. So what that tells me is we need to have more sifting going on with different types of meshes, because the meshes are very important. What you get. You can use some loot bags to help with that, but really the best way to do it is just sift with different meshes. So you want some string meshes and some flint meshes with different materials. So we'll just have to see, you know, what we want to do with that. Not quite sure yet. Okay, we'll go ahead and make some of the next bag up. I think we'll end this episode here. If you want to see more of this, leave a comment, let me know. I may not continue this. Because it's a whole lot of grinding is what it is. I had to cut down trees for hours just to get the stuff for that big chest. So it's a lot of it's going to be either me working off camera just to get materials to show that we build something, or you'll be with me as I do that, because I'm going to have to build probably about, I don't know, at least 6 of these, if not more. I'll have to build another one of these, probably. I have to build a water mill, probably about, well, I can start off with 2, but I'm going to need probably about 10 eventually. This is a great way to get grid power, because it's just passive, but you need a lot of redstone, and you need to split an ender shard. And you see redstone torches, and then with these things, you need one of these resonators, and that takes redstone. I just don't have the redstone right now to build any of that. So, like I said, it's going to be a lot of grinding. So let me know if you enjoy the series. If you want to see more of it, let me know. Otherwise, I may, for now, this may just be it. But I do have some nice hat, some nice shoes. And we do have a decent start here. I think what I will do, I think it's all up here. Just to finish this off, and if we don't ever come back, at least we will have cobblestone when we come back. We'll take one of these, I'll take one of these, I will put you right there. I will put you there, and I will put you right there. So now, if I come into here, and we'll go ahead and dump some of that in there. Probably, where's the cobble? Cobble. 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26. So what I did is I just started pumping it straight into here. So anytime I want cobble, this should have plenty. And it will just do that forever. So anyway, I think I'll wrap the episode up for now, because no matter what I do, I'm going to have to do a lot of grinding to get anything going, because I need lots of everything. Redstone mainly, and that's always the hardest part to get at the beginning is the redstone, because you have to sift the right thing, and I don't believe sifting gravel gets the redstone. I think I have to do that with dust, which means I have to run it through a couple of these, or I got to get a crusher and then through one of these to get to the dust. So anyway, and I can't build the crusher, until I get the redstone. So anyway, that's it for the episode. Again, let me know in the comments what you think, and I will see you later. Bye.